morning. It is Monday. It is Labor Day, so I'm off from work today. And I decided that I'm going to weekly vlog this week. I had mentioned it in what is most likely to be my last video, which was a day in my life on a work day. And I haven't done one. I mean, I did Vlogmas, but I don't really count that as a weekly vlog because I do that every day in December. But I haven't done a weekly vlog since, I think, July of 2020. So it's been quite a while, over a year. But I kind of felt like vlogging, so that's what I'm going to be doing for you this week. Hopefully you don't mind two vloggy sort of style videos in a row. But I've had my breakfast and coffee, and now I'm going to do my workout because when I'm off from work, I like to get them done in the morning and get it completed right away. So I also mentioned in the other video, but in case you didn't see, Emily or MK Fit, whose workouts I've mentioned before, whose challenges I've done before, is doing another challenge in the month of September. And it's the 100 song challenge. So 100 songs of her dance workouts, whether that be a complete hit or she's made some individual videos of just songs for you to do. But here it is, September 6th, and I've done 10 songs. Don't know how I'm gonna make the 100. It is gonna be difficult, but therefore I'm trying to do at least one of the dance videos every day if possible. So I'm going to start out with that, and then I had planned to do one of her more total body strength workouts. So that's what I'm going to get done now. Usually get very sweaty in my workouts, but that one did it. I'm super sweaty now. Plus, my hair's gone crazy. Thanks for a great workout, Emily. It always feels good to have that accomplished. I'm gonna do a quick cool down though, and then get changed. I'm going to head to the pool for a bit because it's probably the last pool day I'll have this year, and I haven't really been that much this summer, so I'm gonna go for a little bit, have a little relaxation and reading time, and then move on to some other things I want to get done today. I made it to the pool, and at the moment, I'm the only person here, which never happens, so that's kind of nice, a nice peaceful, quiet morning at the pool to myself, at least until other people show up, but I'm gonna enjoy it while I can. I'm going to read my book. I'm currently reading The Inheritance Games and rather enjoying it so far. So I'm just gonna chill, relax. Oh, did I mention I found a shady spot? I can't remember if I said that 2 seconds ago, but I did. I found a shady spot, so that's good. And yeah, gonna relax, soak up the last little bit of summer that I can, and enjoy this day. Now going to head to my storage shed to see if I can fit this stuff here behind me. Hopefully I can. And while I'm there, I'm going to pick up my fall decorations so I can get in the fall spirit and decorate for fall a bit. So I'll try to take you along for that if I can. It's always kind of a puzzle and challenge to get stuff in there and out of there, but I'm gonna do my best. And then I have to go to the grocery store because as I look at my food, I'm out of a few of my staples for the week. So I wanna get those because I'm gonna be busy pretty much every other night this week and not have time. So let's get to it. Storage is done, groceries are done. I'm running out of steam. Don't have a lot of energy left for some reason, but it's 4:30 and I'm going to do my fall decorating as I had planned. There's not gonna be a ton, plus I don't have a ton of places to put stuff, but just to have a little fall touches here and there, so I'll show you that once it's complete. Oh, Duncan wants to say hello. He's saying, I haven't been in this vlog yet. Look at me, I want my dinner, but I have an hour to go. Yeah, say hi, vlog. The decorating took no time at all because I really don't have that much. A lot of it is Halloween, and I'm definitely not putting that out till October. So I just put out the fall things, which is mainly pumpkins, but gives a few little nice fall touches here and there. So down on my little table here, I put this little stuffed fall-colored pumpkin, but we'll see how that lasts because Duncan might decide to play with it and then it might have to go, if that's the case. Then in the bedroom, I just put this pink pumpkin. Since I have pink pillows in my bedroom, I thought the pink accent would be nice. Right next to my little candle here, that's a Target Beauty and the Beast themed candle, and it says Rosy Outlook. And then I just did a little small centerpiece here on the table with this runner that I have that has some fall design on the end of it here. I probably could put more on the table, but I think that's good for now because more than likely I'll just end up having to move it when I eat or something like that. Then I have this little green pumpkin that I put next to the stove here because, to be honest, I didn't really know where else to put it. And then in the guest bathroom, I just put this little basket of foliage here because it's small and just gives a nice little touch there on the sink. And then lastly, my mom sent me this new little pumpkin this year. Again, I'm gonna have to be careful with Duncan because I think he thinks it's a toy. I got leaves from Bath and Body Works candle because it's one of my favorite scents and I ran out of it last year, so I got the small version to have this year. I didn't love their designs this year on their candles, but I did want the scent, so I want the small version. I haven't been utilizing my letterboard as much as I would like, so now that we're getting into seasons, I'm gonna try to change it each month with some little seasonal sayings. So I just came up with this one on my own because I didn't really like any fall quotes or anything, and this one was fitting for me, so I like that there. It's kind of welcoming. So again, just some little touches here and there, but starting to get into the festive season, and then in October, I'll add some Halloween touches. I'm just relaxing now, painted my nails, decided to do white because that's what I was in the mood for, and I saw it recently and thought it looked good, so I thought I'd go ahead and do that. No more. I can't wear white after Labor Day. I feel like that rule is passé. But I'm just, now that my nails are drying, or pretty much dry, I'm just relaxing with some shows. Probably gonna try to get to bed somewhat early tonight, but I'll see you tomorrow at some point and throughout the rest of the week.
Good morning. It is Wednesday, not Tuesday, and that's because I didn't vlog yesterday. But the reason is that some things came up that I had to take care of. Plus, there wasn't really much interesting vlog content for you unless you wanted to see another workout, because that's pretty much all I did. So hopefully today will be a little bit more interesting, but I'm headed to work now, but I do have to work late for a meeting tonight, so I'll try to share a little bit of that with you. Hope you are having a great day, and I'll see you later.
Currently covering my meeting. Don't know if you'll be able to hear me. I might have to put captions. But good day now. Just continuing on with my work day. Covering this meeting. It's thrilling stuff.
Most of them fall into the general watershed area or wellhead protection area protected by land conservation. So basically, it's on land around the watershed, in the watershed, or around the well.
2 hours later.
Town, it's public safety and whatever you need of public health or safety.
But I'm ready to go home. Good morning. I'm tired. Those meetings take a lot out of me for some reason. I think it's partly because it gets me off my routine a little bit, gets me off my sleep schedule. Nothing too dramatic, but I just noticed the difference, especially today. And luckily it's only twice a month, so I can get back to normal hopefully over the next couple of days, but I do feel a bit tired and low energy today. And that's why I've gone for the bright lip, because the hope is the bright lip will distract from the tired eyes. Don't know if it works, but it at least makes me feel better. Now I am headed to work. Tonight I have a Lions Parade Committee meeting, so I'll be doing that after work. And so I'll most likely talk to you when I get home. I'm hoping to fit a workout in since I couldn't get one in last night, but we'll see how late it is when I get home and how much energy I have left. Hopefully I'll get a burst this evening, but we will see. So I'll see you later. I'm home now. The meeting went well, and I ordered a couple of shirts. Because I haven't mentioned, but I, as of right now, I'm going to Las Vegas in October for the conference that I used to go for in April, but never happened for the past 2 Aprils, I think. Yeah. And so it's been moved to October, and it's always nice to have a few new things to wear when you go away. And since it's a work trip, I wanted a few little nice new tops to take. So I ordered some stuff from Macy's when they were having a Labor Day sale, and those came in the mail today, so I thought I could do a little try-on haul for you, because I don't get to do those too often. And it's only a few things, but that's okay. So I'm gonna do that now. Hopefully there is enough light for you to see me, but oddly, when I took this out of the bag, it smelled funny. And I don't even want to say what it smelled like because it's bad. So I would definitely have to wash it before I take it away with me. But when I first put it on, it wasn't fitting so great. It kind of caved in. And I don't know if that's the bra that I have on or the way the shirt just laid. Also, it has little holes in it that you can see through, which I didn't realize. So I put a camisole on underneath it. Once I put the camisole on, it definitely fit better. And seems to be a good size fit. It's definitely looking more orange in person than it looked like online. It looked more coral online, but that could be very dependent on light as well. But I think I'm gonna keep it because it's not like anything I have, and it's just a little bit dressier for evenings out. I know it's not very Vegas, because I know people dress every kind of way there, but I think I'll enjoy it. Before I forget, I always forget to say what size the things are. That last shirt was medium. Hey, ow! That last shirt was medium. This is also medium, which I'm glad I went with medium, because large would have been way too big. I think the medium's good. I like the purple. And I know not everybody's a fan of these cold shoulder tops, but I like them. And I at least think that they look flattering on me. So, this is definitely a longer one than I was expecting. And more casual than the last one, but you know, those Vegas air-conditioned rooms can get cold, so might be nice to have the sleeve. But there you go, that's top number two. I never know what angles to use or how close to get because I don't have one of those mirrors that all the fashion bloggers use. This is the last one, and it is also a medium. And I never really know, because some shirts I need large, some I need medium, but fortunately these mediums all worked. Of course, I chose all of these tops because of their colors, because I like coral, and purple and pink are two of my favorite colors. And I like this because while it's kind of a basic, it's a little bit dressier, especially the way the neckline is. So luckily these all worked out for me, and I'll have three nice new tops to take to Las Vegas. So here's a closer look for you in case you want to see it up closer. Again, apologies if these aren't the best shots, but it's just a quick little show you what I got. So there you go. Let me know your favorite down in the comments. Sorry for the sounds of the washer going. I had to do some laundry. But it's 8:30. However, I'm going to do three of Emily's new dance videos so I can get some more challenge videos in. Plus, I just know it will make me feel good to get a little bit of a workout in, a little dance cardio, always kind of pumps me up, makes me feel good and happy. So that's what I'm up to now. I knew her workouts would get me smiling, and they did, so it was worth it. But now I'm going to go and shower and then probably get ready for bed. So I'll say goodnight and talk to you tomorrow. I'm home from work now. Duncan's saying hello, also saying, feed me, but he's got a little while to wait. But I am home, I am tired. Don't want to complain, but that's how I feel. Plus, it's been a weird week. I won't get into detail, but I've just had some strange, weird things happening this week. So let's hope that doesn't keep happening. But I'm about to get changed and get ready for my MK HIIT workout. But before I do that, I wanted to let you know something that I have not told the vlog or videos or anything that I do on YouTube yet. And that is that I have a boyfriend. I went a good amount of time being single on my own, but I do now have a boyfriend. And you know me, I like to be pretty private. Plus, I don't know if he'll be comfortable being in vlogs or videos, so time will tell with that. But the reason I'm telling you is because he's coming here later tonight and will be here until Sunday. So the weekend vlogging could be a challenge, especially if he doesn't want to be in it. But I'll do my best to capture what I can for you either way. But just letting you know about that. So maybe you'll understand if it's a little sporadic or ends up not having a ton of content. So there you go. That's the news. And now I'm off to change and figure out which hit I want to do. I'm about to eat my dinner, but I wanted to share. I've never been a big fan of the Cracker Barrel restaurant. I just don't love their menu items, but we went for our meeting last night and I got the chicken pot pie. And if you like chicken pot pie, I have to say I recommend it, and it's worth going to Cracker Barrel for because it's very tasty and also affordable. If you have a Cracker Barrel near you and like chicken pot pie like I do, check it out. Good morning, it is Sunday. I did not vlog the last couple of days while my boyfriend was here. Don't really know why, no specific reason, just I'm getting back into the swing of vlogging, and it was pretty busy trying to take care of things like brakes on my car, Duncan, different various things that I had to do, so didn't really get the chance to pull out my camera. Also didn't know if it'd really be that interesting for you, so I'll work on that for future vlogs. But today is kind of a catch up on stuff, get things done. I'm doing some laundry, about to do my workout. And one productive thing that we did get done is building a piece of furniture. It's only taken me about a year, but I've been looking for some storage furniture so that I could put some of the things that are in the guest bedroom away, so that I don't have to look at them, but that they have a place and they're not taking up, you know, then I can get rid of some buckets that are taking up space. So I'll show you that later. I have another one that I'll be putting together next week to put more stuff in, but I need to put some of this stuff in it today to make room for the other one. And I should be getting my desk soon. So while it's coming together very slowly, it is coming together, and hopefully before Christmas, it will be completed. And of course, I'll share that with you when it is. But I also need to shower today and doing a video call with the family this afternoon. So, gotta repaint my nails as I do at the end of the week, or just before the week begins, however you want to look at it. Hopefully I can get everything done that I want to. But now, time to work on my fitness. Now that I'm all nice and clean, I'm going to show you the piece of furniture that we put together, and then I'll probably show you once I've made some progress, hopefully. This room is better than it's ever been before, but it's still not ideal. There's still too much stuff in it, but that's why I've got the storage. This here is all the stuff I've still got to deal with and organize. Some of it's going to go in my desk when I get it. And then this here is what we built. I think it came out well, and the other one is identical to it, just so I can kind of put stuff in and hide it away from view. So, gonna get to work. I feel like I've made a bit of progress because now I've got a spot cleared for the other furniture, but this pile almost looks worse than it did before. It probably looks like I just moved everything over and piled it higher, but that's not the case. I did get rid of two boxes and completely emptied this black and yellow bucket that's here and put the stuff that was in there in the shelving along with what was in those other two boxes, and then put other loose stuff in the bucket for now until I get the other one that I can put other stuff in. But let me show you what I put in here. So on the top shelf, I've got my willow trees, my princesses, and my Boyd's bears. One of my princesses is a little bit broken, so I've kept her out for now until I can super glue her back together. And then down here, I've got one other princess that wouldn't fit, all my fake flowers and plants, and then candles. And I think this is going to work out a lot better for the candles because I've always had them in a bucket or a bag, and it makes it really difficult to see what I have, whereas now I can see exactly what I have and, you know, what seasons and that sort of stuff. So the majority of them are Christmas scents. I don't think I'm going to need any Christmas scents for quite some time because I've got a bunch in here that have never even been burned. But yeah, it will help me keep better track of what I've got for candles and if there's any that I would want to purchase. And I think it will also let me use the plants more so. As you can see, I put some little fall themed decor up there. It's progress and a step in the right direction. Once I have the other one set up and my desk, I'll have a much better idea because a lot of this is like office supply stuff that would clear out even more buckets because like one bucket's just filled with a printer. So although I could put the printer on top of one of it, I don't know, we'll see. But yeah, I'll have a better idea once I have the other shelving and my desk. And then I'll know if I need more, or if I need to get rid of stuff, or how I want to manage all of this. But every step is a little step closer to me having it more the way I want, but I have a feeling that there's going to maybe be more stuff that I have to get rid of at some point. But deal with that when the time comes. And yeah, go from there. But that's the update. Hopefully next time I'm vlogging for you, I will have a completed, or even if not completed decor-wise, at least completed furniture and organization-wise. Hopefully that will happen by the next time I talk to you and I'll have a little more progress to show you. Trying to just appreciate what I did get to accomplish and that I'm heading toward where I want it to be. And now I have about half an hour until the video call with my family, so I'm gonna probably grab a snack, relax for a bit, and then chat with them. Nails are done, I've gone from light to dark, but now it's time to get ready for bed. And so I'm going to end this weekly vlog here. I hope that you've enjoyed it. And let me know what you would like to see in future weekly vlogs. And I will see you soon in my next video.